It's been a grim week for media, with more journalism jobs lost than at any other point in our history. But along with News Hub and TVNZ Current Affairs, another outlet has announced it's struggling to stay afloat. Here's Fenner Owen.
New Zealand, it's time for a reality check. Reality check. RCR, Reality Check Radio.
Just over a year ago, Aucklanders who looked to the skies may have seen this plane towing a banner. RIP Woke Media, it said. It heralded the start of Reality Check Radio and, along with billboards and mass pamphleting, the impression that some serious money was backing the startup. But 13 months later, Reality Check Radio, or RCR, is suddenly off the air and pleading for money via a lengthy and slick video.
The only way we're going to get back on air is by raising funds now.
I find it weird that an organisation would put so much effort into telling people they'd failed.
Sarah over there just keeps the office running.
Sean Plunket, editor of another media startup, is showing us through the platform's expanding operation and pondering Reality Check Radio's sudden radio silence.
So I'm not sure if it isn't some sort of misguided sort of marketing ploy, to be honest. But once again, I haven't lost a wink of sleep wondering what's happening at Rabbit Hole Radio.
The fact that people like Plunket, Sean Plunket, call it Rabbit Hole Radio.
Longtime broadcaster and RCR presenter Peter Williams.
Why is he so worried about RCR and the fact that it's off air at the moment if he doesn't regard it as a real threat to his audience?
You're with Sean Plunket on the platform today.
The platform is funded by a wealthy New Zealand family, The Rights. It claims to have around just under 262,000 listeners or viewers to their website or app and 1,200,000 visits a month to its social media.
There was certainly nobody that big or putting that amount of money into RCR right from the start, but there were some people of means, shall we put it, who were prepared to support the cause. And that was, I guess you'd call that, the seed capital, the startup capital. Ever since then, it's been just a dribs and drabs feed.
In just over 1 year since going on air, RCR has had over 350,000 Kiwis listen live.
Is that correct?
In over a year, we've had over 350,000 Kiwis tuning in to RCR.
Voices for Freedom, who generally don't speak to so-called legacy media, have decided to talk to Q&A. Ali Abi was one of the co-founders of Reality Check Radio.
Is this a marketing gimmick? I mean, are you just wanting to expand the business and so you've stopped it to get attention?
People have said that. That's been a strong criticism that's out there. Yes, they have. It's not the truth of the matter, though, is that because of the way we came out in the first instance, the situation was dire. We felt that what was needed was something to come out really strong from the beginning. I know that our listeners would like us to stick around and that it's just a matter of vying for the attention that is out there. You know, everything wants your attention right now. You have to find a way to get your point across to people. So it's completely genuine. It is the situation warranted that approach. And I think it's, you know, it's having a good result.
You hide, you know, you're afraid.
We want freedom!
Absolutely disgusting that you media have never told the truth.
Now you're
Voices for Freedom have their roots in the so-called anti-vax movement. The idea of RCR was born out of the Parliament occupation. It saw a niche then to meet the needs of New Zealanders who felt unrepresented.
Taking on the mainstream, Chantelle Baker.
Mainstream media, as usual, in their little perch.
The man who cares so much and whose background is for real, Rodney Hyde.
Former ACT leader Rodney Hyde's RCR journey also began at the Parliament protest, but RCR presenters have since widened their key topics beyond their COVID concerns.
Well, that's what's crystallised it for me. Big topics weren't being discussed in the news and you couldn't partake. Things like, you know, treaty issues, climate change.
When they talk about co-governance, they're actually talking about dividing us.
Social credit system, 15-minute cities.
Well, that's what Reality Check Radio is all about. It's
politicians, mostly right of centre, have been interviewed on Reality Check Radio. Over on the platform, most political parties have come on, but not, its editor says, the Greens.
They are trying to cancel us. I will keep asking.
But this week on the platform, it's all about the media.
Sean, all I'm asking from you is some professional courtesy.
OK, Paddy, so here's the professional courtesy.
Hey, Sean, stop for a second. Stop showing off to your listeners and just show a bit of professional courtesy and say, hey, Paddy, why don't you come on and do an interview?
The shrinking of mainstream media and the plummeting of trust in it is seen as timely for alternative start-up media. The donations, Alia B says, are starting to roll in.
The media landscape right now is a perfect opportunity to be, you know, really putting in your roots and being solid, having a solid foundation to take off.
I'll be honest, the platform doesn't have the answer yet, and there may never be a definitive answer. The world is moving much more quickly than it used to. So in those circumstances, I think what journalists and the media have to do is clearly define what their principles are, and whatever the technical environment they're in, stick to those principles and communicate with the potential audience.
Fighting and defending yourself.
Yeah.
Are you good at it?
Down in central Otago, Rodney Hyde is keeping his Reality Check Radio hat on. He soon hopes to be back behind the microphone.
We're not dead, but we need life support.